What are 6 crazy artificial intelligence powered life hacks you can do right now to make your life easier? From cooking, to doing your homework, to even sorting out your 5-year life goals. We're gonna list out the most important ones. We're also gonna give you some limitations of artificial intelligence as well. Because goddamn, this thing is not gonna replace me. Oh, wait, actually it might. Are you hungry? Cause I am, but I have no idea what to eat. Well, that solution is solved because you can literally take a photo of what's inside your fridge and then ask GPT to come up with recipes and suggestions of what to eat. Holy crap. From fruit salad, cheese omelets, it's way more creative than I am. What's even more crazy is you can ask GPT to come up with entire meal plans with specific dietary requirements. For example, I'm going back into keto, so I'm asking it for a keto meal plan, and I'm giving it specific instructions for the first week of keto, so it can load me up on more of the oils. All right, one caveat though is that GPT-4 is not a qualified nutritionist. So usually what I do is I kind of check what the meals are, what the ideas are, and I double check that with factual information on the internet first. Now, if only GPT can cook that for me, my life is sorted. The next one is something that GPT itself came up with. It's scary, but are you a terrible liar? GPT-4 can make the wildest excuses sound possible. Need a reason to skip work or dodge a blind date? Let GPT-4 spin a tale so compelling you won't believe it in yourself. I'm not sure what I'm more scared of. You can use GPT-4 to get out of your commitments, or GPT-4 is actively telling me that we should use it to lie. You can use GPT-4 in a lot of work applications. Say, for example, I'm a coder and I want to get Bitcoin prices from the CoinDesk API. By using Copilot while I'm programming, I can literally get GPT to write the code for me. And the crazy part is I can start getting the code line by line. It's actually quite scary. You can also call GPT on Excel spreadsheets and get basic information like how many people live in a certain city or whatnot. A pro tip here is that sometimes plugins use an older version of GPT and the results are not as good. So what you can do is you can just ask ChatGPT how to do it for you, and usually you'll get even better results. Say for example, when I said earlier, I want to write that Python code, ChatGPT not only gave me the instructions, but I could also ask further how to complete each step if I'm stuck. So that's always very helpful. The next one I did personally. You can use GPT to write formal letters for you because I absolutely hate those. Now I got like some surcharges on my credit card bills and I asked ChatGPT to write a formal letter to get a refund back for those late handling charges. I even asked GPT to be a little bit demanding, to threaten the bank that if they don't give me a refund, I'll just leave and pull my money out. And not only did ChatGPT write this letter, I pretty much copy and pasted it, sent that to the bank and got my refund, which is pretty amazing. Remember, it can be very specific when it comes to GPT. It accepts up to 25,000 words as input. So by being more specific, you can tailor professional letters to your specific needs and case, which makes it much more compelling. I'm tired of those spam calls because GPT-4 can write angry lawyer letters to sue the living crap out of those robo spam callers that you're getting. Someone has literally recorded the conversation that the robo callers gave and just filed off a lawsuit for literally free. What's kind of crazy here is that GPT actually scored a top 90th percentile on the LSAT exam. So it knows a little bit about law. But there is a limitation here. Because GPT is built to predict words following each other and not actually having full intelligence, it's not fully a substitute for a lawyer just yet. So if you have actual literal legal advice, yeah, it's still best to consult a lawyer. Are you traveling soon? Because GPT-4 can come up with an entire itinerary for a trip, including what you should do, what you should pack, how much you should bring, what you eat. Pretty much AI can run your entire vacation. I find this better than Google and looking up other guides because a lot of times they have sponsored content, but GPT is much more plain and direct. Also, remember to be specific. You're gonna get much better results this way. So if you ask it or give it your budget of how much you wanna spend per day, or you can ask it about specific travel arrangements that you have, or what you like, whether it's sightseeing or going to see particular events. If you have an idea, general idea of what you want to do, you're going to get much better results. And honestly, I did go to Thailand recently before all this tech. And honestly, I look at this one and it's like, it's pretty good. The only thing it didn't warn me about was just the crazy traffic jams in Bangkok. But yeah, it's not bad. All right, folks, those are the top 6 GPT-4 life hacks. To be honest, I'm quite surprised at the extent and how crazy it can do things. In fact, if you want, you can also use the mobile apps. There's plenty on the market right now that you can use and browse to get GPT on your mobile phone so you don't have to use a computer. I'm pretty shocked at how much technology has progressed, and I'm stunned at the results. They're actually quite good. Obviously, you know, don't follow everything and don't blindly do what AI says. There's still a lot of kinks in the progress, but I'm pretty scared at how fast this is growing and where it can go and how drastically it can improve our lives. I hope that you find them useful. If you have other life hacks, share them down below. I would love to share them more with this community. And if you found them useful as well and you just give up some examples, I'd love to hear how it improved your life too. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you like more content like this, make sure you click the subscribe button, bell icon, and yeah, see you next week.